What's up, y'all? Hey, welcome to Mix It Up. We mixing it up. Hey, I have my homie. Like, this is like my homie, Ololade, aka Lola. Olamigoke.
Hello. Hello. Hi. I'm ready to mix it up with you, April.
I'm so ready.
April.
That's what she called. So she called me April. With that extra emphasis, and I call her Lola, but her birth name is Olola Day.
Yes, yes, yes. And we're not going to talk about Costco.
We're not. Well, okay, first of all, before we hit record, you guys, we were having a whole conversation about grocery shopping. We're talking about Costco, which I said it twice. Now they need to like give us some sponsorship money. But anyway.
Oh, yeah.
That's okay.
But they're good. It's really good.
I
have a lot of good organic products and healthy products.
I can't with that crowd. It's too clustered and too.
It is crazy. It is crazy.
The size is too much.
It is.
But
all right, what are we going to talk about today?
We are going to talk about you, talking about us, how we know each other, and talk about the delicious food that we're about to partake in.
All right.
Dinner's ready?
No, we're clearing the space. Energy ready. Let's go.
Okay, look. So you guys, Lola is my very, I don't want to say crunchy. You're crunchy though. And okay, so you guys, she lives in LA. So she's been living in LA for quite some time. And I know each other. We went to college together and eventually made our way to New York.
You went to New York first. And then I think some years after I moved up to New York.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Right, because you were in, wait, where were you before you were here in New York?
Girl, my blood was running dry in Virginia.
Oh yeah, that's right.
And as soon as I could, I moved up to New York, yeah.
Here, and you just were just...
Yeah, I moved, actually, the reason why I moved was because I got into Fashion Institute of Technology. So I was starting my footwear career, and that's how that happened, yeah.
Right. Yes, mm-hmm. That's a perfect segue. So you guys, Lola is a footwear designer. Like her background in the world is footwear design, and she has expanded into designing accessories, jewelry. You're wearing some of your jewelry. I see it looks beautiful. Can you get close?
Thank you. What, you want me to come close, you said?
Yeah, I want them to see the...
Can you see?
Oh, those are nice.
Yeah, this is part of the new stuff I'm working on.
Where are those beads? Are the beads...
the beads, everything's pretty much like a upcycle thing, you know. Rebirth is like my inspiration, so taking things that would have been considered trash and giving them new life and making them like beautiful, basically. So what this is, the bead, the center bead is Kenyan bone bead. So basically from discarded bones from food, then they carved them out. And then they batik dyed them. So this one is a polka dot print, right? So, and for me, it's all about the story behind it. And it was basically about, you know, having a need, needing money, basically, to make it simple. But taking something that was trash, making it into beads, selling it, and really transcending from poverty to a place where you can support your family with, you know, something that was discarded before. So for me, that, I feel like there's a lot of power behind that. And so how I came up, what I do with it is this, I take pieces from different things. Like the chain has been like with the metal chains, it's basically pieces that I found when I was traveling, when I was working in Brazil, like on shoes, I would get some chain from there, or traveling to Santa Barbara, whatever, wherever it is, I just like to source chain and stuff. So I bring things together and I feel like it's like Lego, you know, how kids would play with Lego. I never did.
Or like you're collaging.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Yeah. So just pulling pieces together. And so that's the bone bead. This is resin bead. Mm. And this is something I sourced in Nigeria. Yes. And then
that's,
I had some pieces.
That you guys, Lola is Nigerian American.
Yeah.
Yoruba. Yeah. Yes.
Okay. Yeah, there you go, girl. Yes. And last time I went was 2014. And that was even a journey too, because I was trying to find where they were selling the beads. And for some reason, they call them Malams. They're from the northern Nigeria, but they're just like oppressed in a certain way. I don't know. It's just like some type, I don't know what the politics behind it is, but what I was getting was that where they were was pushed away. Like they just kept getting pushed and pushed wherever they were selling. So I'm like, oh, are they here? So we'll go to the hotel where they said they were selling their beads and then they're gone. And finally one day, it's sweltering hot. We found the area where, you know, they were selling their goods, like snakeskin sandals, beads and everything. So it was just like searching through everything, finding beads. Like that was so fun. Mm-hmm. And so, yeah, that's where I got those from. And
story.
There's your, a pearl like, on
jewelry,
there.
Your jewelry has a journey. Like your jewelry has been through like life.
Yeah, that's the thing. That's what I love about it, because it's like, it's the story behind it. You know, I'm always searching for what the root cause is for whatever. What's the meaning behind whatever it is? And I feel like that's where the empowerment comes. That's where the joy comes. That's where the beauty is. And so naturally, I guess that's why I gravitated towards creating the pieces. Even like it kind of even started from my mom, because she had like leftover pearls like this. The top piece is like a pearl. Is it a pearl? Yeah, it's a pearl. The tiny little piece at the top is a pearl. And then so I collected some of her old stuff, and I'm like, I'm not going to be beading, because there's this like whole world of beaders. Like, that is not me. Like
crafty. So meticulous. Like you need to wear bifocals or something to bead.
Yeah. I felt like it was like scrapbooking, and I'm like, that is not me.
No, that's
I'm not going to be doing all of that.
No, you guys, Lola is very high end and just with a very pristine eye. So, yeah. Shout out to your mom. How's she doing?
Yeah, she's good. She's in Atlanta, Georgia, doing her thing. Yeah, she's a nurse, you know, so a lot of prayers. Let me just side note, I learned why our parents, our ancestors prayed so much. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I get it now.
Can you tell, Lord, my knees are like chafed.
Really? You get on your knees, girl?
I mean, no. Okay, I'm not on my knees, actually. Right. You call me out. I'm not on nobody's knees.
But I get it.
I'm sitting in lotus position, meditating, you know, praying, meditating, whatever you want.
Yeah,
for sure. Like, these are the times. Yeah. Definitely to tap into that.
For sure. I mean, I think prayer is one thing, meditation is another thing, contemplation is another thing. And all of these different practices have been really beneficial for me right now. Yeah. And I just got a better sense of like, wow, I get it now. Mm-hmm. Any Nigerian will tell you, parents be praying, you know? I mean, I guess.
I think that's a black, don't you think that's just a black thing, diaspora, like diaspora-wise? Like people, black people pray, Like, it'll be a whole, literal prayer circle.
Yes, and I get it. I get it now.
And I actually, like, it works. Like, you know, I mean, this is a whole other discussion. I mean, I see the beauty in religion, but I see the corruption, the aggressive corruption.
That's religion.
That's religion, right. But when you get to the root of it, like the spirit of it, right?
Yeah, spirituality.
It's energy. It's like that prayer, that meditation, literally like sound waves that like emit.
Exactly.
Yeah, we better be. Yeah. What's her name? Ayamba. I can never say her name. Ayamba.
Yeah. No, I agree. I mean, what you put your energy to really, you know, manifest in some way or not, right? Mm-hmm. And so, yeah, that's been really helpful so far. But yeah, we went all the way around.
I know, right? Well, speaking of manifesting, we manifested a meal.
Mm-hmm.
We manifested the recipe. It's really good. Like, I sampled a little bit before we started, but yeah, tell everybody what we're about to partake.
Okay. First of all, I'm glad you liked it. I'm very happy about that. So this, should I show it now?
Yeah, for sure.
Mine's not very pretty, but don't worry about it because it tastes really
good. Mine tastes good, yeah.
Yeah, these are plantain, I call it plantain wrap. You could even make it into a tortilla or plantain flatbread. And this all started for me like in 2017 when I realized like after working with like a functional doctor to figure out, oh, why are my joints hurting when I'm doing out here in LA doing my, what is it, body pump class? My muscles aren't tired.
I see. Y'all see the muscles. I see the muscles.
Yeah, that's from my little weights. That's another story. Working out in the hills. It's really nice. Mm. But 2017, just noticing like different symptoms. Like, why are my joints hurting? You know, what's that about? Right. You know, it's not that my muscle was tired, but it just felt like my joint was gonna pop, girl.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. And so just wanted to, again, looking for what the root cause is, right? Mm-hmm. So just really learning and just researching like different opinions or modalities. Found someone and we went through a whole protocol of like eliminating gluten. It was called a leaky gut protocol, which is like your base, getting to your baseline where your digestive system is just calm and then you can figure out what's going on.
Right.
So, whew, that was crazy because I had to get rid of gluten and I don't know if you know, but bread, it was like a brand.
What's your brand?
Bread.
Bread.
Yeah, so that was tough. And I'm like, okay, if I'm going to really commit to this, I need to figure out a way. It felt so limiting because there was a lot of food that I had to eliminate. But I had a really good, great conversation with a friend that said, you know what, shift your perspective and consider incorporating more tasty, good things. Mm. And when you do that, naturally, you're going to stop eating the bad. So focus on good that tastes good, that you like, and, you know, slowly you eliminate the bad. So anyway, so I'm like, I love plantain. I tell everyone, when I was in Nigeria in 2014, I had plantains every day, girl. Yes. Plantains in the morning, boiled plantains in the morning, fried plantain dodo with my beans. I have plantain, yam, and beans, like any way, always. So I just automatically went to plantain and yam, right?
Yeah.
And
but so, those ingredients, I mean, you can really transform them into anything.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. So that's where it started. It's like, what can I do with plantain? And started researching and then testing out. And that's how this came about, you know? And I'm like, oh, wow, this tastes so good. What else can I do with it? And I'm all about flavor, sauces, you know, textures and so on. And that's kind of how this started. And
So it's here for it. It's so good. I didn't think when you said it, I was like, huh? I was looking it up because I found a recipe that actually literally calls for like three ingredients. Like you just boil the plantain. So I guess,
okay. Tell me about your recipe you use.
Yeah, it's so basic. So you can
use,
green plantains, or you can use like the ripe. I like meat, so I went for like being, you know, like a more ripened, like equivalent of a maduro, like maduro versus like pasta, right? So I slice that and then you boil it for like 12 minutes or whatever, and then I blended it. And now in hindsight, I should use the food processor, but I blended it and I added a little bit of water and salt. And made like it, you know, sticky. And then put gluten free because I can't do gluten. Like I literally cannot digest it anymore. So I did like gluten free flour, like to spread it out on like a cutting board, and just rolled the like dough, like the plantain dough.
Oh, okay.
And then just kind of blended the dough in because it's really sticky. So I just, you know, and
yeah, that gluten flour to help, you know, cut the stickiness.
And then. Fried it up on the stove, and I was like, wow.
Oh, you fried it. Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
I know. It was, I mean, yeah.
That was a lot of steps.
Really?
But it looks really cute. Let's see it, though, because I really love it.
Yes, you guys. So I have to, I can't lie. June, who I've talked about her in past sessions, June is my fiance, and she's a chef. So whenever I'm in the kitchen attempting to do something, she's always like, stepping in like, girl, like, what are you doing? So it was very bad. And so she like cut them out into they're like little mini tortillas.
Bring it closer.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's really cute. I love the shape of it. It's like a little hors d'oeuvre type, but you know, you can pass that around and it looks so nice. And put your big things on top.
Exactly.
Okay. Go ahead.
You go ahead. What were you gonna say? Go for it.
Okay, so I was gonna say for mine, and I think you were saying that yours was impliable. Hearing how you did it, I think because of the water and also boiling it made it a little bit more liquidy, right? Which is cool for the tortilla. For the flatbread, I literally just take the, I like sweet plantains too, so hey. I took a sweet plantain, I chopped it up, and let me show you the blender. You don't need a food processor, blender is great. And again, when I was going through this process, I'm like, I need things to be so simple, stupid.
Yeah. Right?
So it was because it was a lot like just cooking and prepping and stuff. I need simple things. So I just put in the blender. This is just a regular blend tech. Uh-huh. It's been used a lot. Can you tell?
Yeah.
Right? Huh. So I put the plantain in there, and then I just put a dash of olive oil. And then I love spices, so I use like garam masala, just a little bit of salt, just depending on how I feel.
You could probably also use barberry, the Ethiopian spice.
Yes, you can. Mm. Yes, you can. If you want a little spicy, I wanted to use a little chipotle powder, but I ran out. But it just depends on how you want it. Remember, it's sweet, and think about what you're gonna put on top of it. And then I blended it. Oh, and then I used coconut cream. And let me just say.
That sounds so rich.
Just a little bit, again, just a dash. This is the best coconut cream. Girl, this
girl, is the one. Gotta cover that label up.
Oh,
brand.
Yeah. You gotta tell me. Okay, you're gonna have to edit this. I know you don't want to edit, but you gotta edit that
I'm
part.
I'm gonna write to them and be like, we just shouted you out. Where's the points at?
Yo. I'm horrible with that because you don't understand how many times I send people when I find something good, I'm like the ambassador without getting paid.
But that's just, you know, that's your communal spirit, which I love. Wait, so where
I want to get my points too.
We're going to get them. Trust me. Trust me.
Yes. So, okay, going back to this, I put a little dash into the blender, blend it all up. And then I want to make sure the consistency is like a cake batter, right? Mm-hmm. So I line a pan and I put parchment paper on it and then I just pour it in and I literally use one of these spatulas, like a bigger one. And my main thing is just to get it nice and smooth on the top.
Yeah.
And I bake it 375 for like 40 minutes, maybe flip it.
Oh, you baked it. Oh, okay, nice.
I baked it. Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
So different ways, you know, it's very versatile. Like you got your tortilla out of it. You can do a baked version. Just
baked
great.
It. So I was struggling, and this is when June had to step in, because you have to, like, when you're frying it, you need to flip it. And the texture, like you said, it was, like, kind of crumbly.
Because
of the water. So I had to add olive oil to it to kind of, like, let, you know, so it kind of held together. But even still, like, the flipping it, you have to have a very steady hand. And my hand's a little shaky, so.
That's why she said it was, like, crepe.
Yeah.
I see what you're saying.
What are your fixings though? What are you?
Oh, okay. Let's talk about the fixings because that's key too. Today, I got garlic spread. We have this international grocery store. Again, look, this is really simple. So your ingredients are important. Like I don't slack on the little ingredients. Like this is great garlic spread.
Ooh, it looks like whipped. Did you whip it?
Yeah. No. That's just what they do. I mean, that's how they do it. And it's just so good. Like Trader Joe sells one, but it's good if that's all you have, but you want to get good quality, you know, garlic spread.
Yeah, that looks great. So fluffy.
The flavor is so good, girl.
Ooh,
so good.
I love garlic,
And from the same place, just a black olive tapenade, I guess.
Yeah.
Is that what it is? Mm-hmm. A black olive paste, and it has some olive oil in it. And then I need to avoid tomatoes, but sun-dried tomato.
Wait, why do you have to avoid tomatoes? You have allergies?
It's nightshade.
Oh, right, yes. Yeah. Gotcha.
And I never paid attention to that till a couple of weeks ago. We went to the farm, got a mad potato, tomatoes, and I was just cooking tomatoes, like different things for 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Ooh, girl, my stomach was just feeling so,
Like someone was like stabbing you in your stomach. Like,
yes. I'm like, what's going on?
Yeah, all that.
And then it has to be that. So, it's all good. I still use it sometimes. Moderation.
What is
red
that?
Onions?
Oh, okay, yeah. Ooh, yeah.
Yeah. Cilantro.
Mm-hmm.
And then just some spring mix greens.
Good.
You know what I forgot is my avocado. It's in the fridge. But avocado is key.
Yeah.
Yeah, nice avocado. What do you have?
Okay, well, again, I got a shout out to June because she did a lot of this, most of it.
Oh, yeah.
So we have here, okay, let me try to, it's yellow tomato. I feel like tomato, like, it's such a good season for tomatoes. Like, tomatoes are delicious. And the key is making sure you get, like, a tomato that tastes like something. Because, like, a lot of times when you get, like, your typical tomatoes in the grocery store, they don't have taste. Yeah. So you need to get like the, I would recommend getting like an heirloom tomato, or like go to your farmer's market, right? And get like a ripe tomato where almost like you don't even need, I mean, there's lots of spices in here, but when a tomato is good, it's like you don't even need anything. You just
you can just eat it like that.
Yeah, no, seriously. So really ripe yellow tomato, really ripe, you know, basic red tomato, cucumber, also red onions. And some cilantro, and what else should you put here? Oh, peaches.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice. So it's like a peach pico de gallo, basically.
Nice. Nice.
And the avocado is in the form of a crema. So this is
what?
Yeah, it's like sour cream and avocado.
Fancy.
I know. I can't take credit for fancy.
Don't you?
Because I don't like a lot of steps. Like for me, I wouldn't have made a crema. I would have just cut up some avocado and just put the sour cream or whatever.
But that looks so good. Yeah. That looks worth it. Yeah. And you didn't have to do it. So hello.
I
know. You got the best.
I'm guilty sometimes. But yeah. So
no.
I'm actually gonna eat some of this.
Yeah, let's eat.
Don't feel like you, yeah.
Let's put it on, put it together, yeah. Right?
We'll continue to chat it up.
Okay.
This time,
are you gonna put agave in that little spritzer?
Yes, for you guys. This is rare that I'm not drinking an alcoholic beverage on screen. This is a it's a peach black tea and it's sparkling, but it doesn't have any sweetener in it, and it's kind of like black tea can be kind of bitter, so I'm adding a little bit of agave.
I love anything with some, you know, a spritz to it, or what, sparkling.
Sparkle, yeah. Yes, I'm so glad we're doing this. So wait, so keep telling us about what is going on.
I love that tool, man.
In your world.
Oh, well, quarantine-ing still. I feel like I'm what we are, Joe and I, my partner, one of the few left that aren't like venturing out like that.
What do you mean venturing out
so what we really, when we go out, we're either going to the grocery store or to work out, and we found some places in the neighborhood, like in the different estates, that have like really great hills, like steep hills, and we work out there. Or in LA, there's so many hidden stairway areas, like with like mad stairs going down, and you can just like go up and down, whatever, and get a good workout. So found some of those, just staying away from people. And like we haven't gone out to eat or anything like that, picked up food or nothing like that. And yeah, or travel, which has been really tough. Yeah. So I just feel like, and then some friends would always like ask, you know, I'm going on a road trip, you want to come? It's like, yes, I want to come, but girl, I don't feel comfortable.
We are still in a whole, I don't know why people don't think that we're still in a pandemic.
I mean, it's hard because it's like, you want to adapt and continue, but what is your comfort zone, you know?
You have like, to your comfort zone, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm noticing like, you know, everyone has different levels of comfort zone, and we're really comfortable, you know, staying at home.
No, and it's good. And thankfully, you guys get along, and you genuinely, I mean, you're partners, but you act, not all partners like really like each other, which is kind of sad. But you actually enjoy spending time with each other.
Yes, yes.
So
that's
probably why you feel even more like cool with just like falling back, you know, and not having to like feel pressure to like try to like get back into the swing of things. Like, what does that even look like right now, you know?
Yeah, at the same time, I feel like it's important to define what that looks like, you know, because how long can I sustain this? You know, I miss like, yeah, when you said crunchy, I did get a little granola, at the same time, I feel like moving from New York to LA, my quality of life expanded.
Yes.
You know, because you, right? Like camping is a thing. And just being in nature, like just being immersed in trees or just something greater than myself helps to create a level of perspective that keeps me grounded, right? Mm-hmm. I always had a difficult time staying grounded. I would feel like I'm floating, right? But just being in this environment, knowing that we can go camping and just like be there or even go hiking and just have that moment in time to reset has really helped.
Yeah.
But with the with what's going on now, like the camping trips were cut off. Even going to Griffith Park, which is literally right there, like we could just walk up.
Yeah.
Don't do that as much because, yo, people are out here feeling like it's just summertime and let's sunbathe on the lawn and they're all close to each other. So it's like, okay, we're not going to do that. We're not going to do this. But how long can you sustain not doing certain things that just give you life on a daily basis, right? So it's like redefining what that is.
Exactly. Right? Okay, you redefine it. You get creative. You create new ways of connecting and finding your way. And you're so right, right. about nature. Like, every day I've been going to Randall's Island. Do you remember Randall's Island? I don't know if you ever went to Randall's Island over here.
I know it. No, it's not I'm thinking Governor's Island. No, yeah, I've never been to Randall's Island.
Yeah, Randall's Island is like a hidden gem because most people would go to Governor's Island. It's like, you know, cute and landscapes. I would only go to Randall's Island because there's this big art fair that happens there. And so for me, I would like associate it with like work in a sense, you know, because I'm like going to this fair. But yep. I didn't realize how beautiful it is. Like, it's so, like, there's all these, like, wildflowers, the trees are, like, you know, beautiful. So I sit out, like, almost every weekday, like, I sit under a tree, and I'm just, like, and it's by the water. So, you know, I'll do some work, I'll meditate, I'll just, like, you know, get into my, like, the grounded space that you're talking about. Like, it's really, it's amazing. I'm like, oh, yeah, like, I've been sleeping on nature. Like, I really haven't.
Yeah.
Well, you know what? Did I tell you that I went to, I went to Aspen.
Yeah, that was amazing.
That was cool because I was DJing out there. And
was that like your first time like really having that experience or I guess connecting to nature in a greater way than before? Was that your first time?
Since
living in New York and as an adult.
Yeah. Really,
yeah.
Right, as an adult, because like as a child, I was like nature girl in a sense. Like I would always feel fine. I'd be like digging in the dirt and just really, it's so weird. Because anybody who knows me would be like, "What? It's digging in the dirt? Like that's just like not the vibe." But I'm like getting back to that, you know, that inner child, that like April, you know, where it's like, oh, yo, like I used to really be into this, so. Mm-hmm. Going to Aspen kind of reawakened that because like I went hiking, we were like in the mountains and just it was gorgeous. So that kind of helped like snap me back into that reality.
That's cool that you had that that experience. I think that was like a couple of years ago, right?
Yeah, it was like over a year ago. Yeah.
Yeah, because we talked about it last year when you were out here in San Diego.
Yeah.
And I saw the pictures and I'm like, oh, that's so amazing. And I think you had done it a couple months before. So maybe a year and a half or so ago.
Huh? Yeah.
Which is great because, go ahead.
No, finish. What were you going to say? It's great because what?
I'm saying that's great that you had that experience before this experience.
Yeah.
Because it's kind of like you had something to go, you know, you had a sense of something to go to.
And right, like I have a memory, you know, that I can refer to, and it's so important. But you know what? Even if you don't have that memory, you didn't have that experience, now is the time to just create it in whatever way. It can be small. I mean, New York is tricky, but you can still do it. Like, grow some herbs. Like, grow some herbs in your window. Like, get some flowers. Like, you know, just little things that will just help kind of. Okay, now I'm gonna sound all granola and crunchy, but help raise your vibration, you know?
Hell yeah, man.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. We gotta raise our vibration right now or we're not going to sustain ourselves. Everyone's talking about sustainability, which is key, right? It's all connected. But hello, let's sustain this.
Yeah.
Let's sustain ourselves. It's At so one true. Point, it was about survival.
And I'm like, now I need to shift it to sustaining my well-being and thriving.
Thriving. Listen, surviving, no, that's for the birds right now.
I mean,
right now.
Yeah.
This is they're not about survival anymore. Like, we're past that. So, yeah. Right.
And that's why, you know, this brings me, like, joy just to be able to use, like, as simple as plantain wraps or cassava flour, whatever I make. It just gave me a sense of empowerment because, yes, I use the creative mind to figure out something else that wasn't available to me, right? Yeah. And just to make sure when I'm eating, I'm feeling joy because I don't want to feel like I'm eating cardboard boxes.
No.
Because I'm trying to be, you know.
Speaking of eating cardboard boxes, you know what's so funny?
What?
The last time I was out, and this is like my first and last time, I've only been to LA once, which boggles my mind. Yeah.
You've been twice. Oh, you mean LA, not California. Okay.
Yeah. Right, yeah.
The first time you went to LA, tell me.
Yes. So my first and last time in LA, which is crazy,
I've
been to LA once. I went to this raw food restaurant, which I feel like you told me about. You told me about this place because I would have never, like, I don't know, raw food.
Sage?
What's it called?
Sage or Cafe Gratitude?
I feel like it was Cafe Gratitude. Yes, it was Cafe Gratitude. And oh my God, it was delicious. So I left LA thinking like, oh my God, like I'm going to try to do raw food and la 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 la. And I was like looking up all these recipes. I was gonna get like a dehydrator, you know, to really kind of like just.
I got one.
I know you do, bro. So let me tell you how I looked up this raw chili recipe. I like soaked the like lentils overnight. I did all the soaking things that you do.
So much work.
Shucking the corn. I'm like shaving sweet potatoes, so you know they're raw. Like so, but you can chew them because they're shaved. And I don't even know what else I added to this thing. Added all like the seasonings on earth. And I was like, I actually was like gassing myself up. I'm like, oh my God, this is gonna be so lit. It's gonna be so good. When I ate that first spoonful, girl, I was so. You talk about low vibration. My vibration was totally flatlined. It was so, it tasted like, I don't even know how to describe the taste, which is why I really have a respect for like raw food chefs, because you gotta know what you're doing. Like, you really have to layer the like, you know.
The textures, the flavor, like everything.
Exactly.
The acid to like maybe cook, you know, break it down.
Gosh. Yeah, because otherwise it's gonna taste like you're eating like raw lima beans. Like it was just. It was so unfulfilling. I was so sad, and I had to like just.
And all that work.
It was all that work, girl. I was like, no, okay.
Mm-mm. Yeah, I think you went to Cafe Gratitude, maybe.
Yeah,
I went
to Cafe Gratitude. Yeah.
Did you ever check out Sage too?
I feel like you mentioned Sage. I don't know if I got around to checking it out though.
Yeah, yeah, they have raw and cooked foods at Cafe Gratitude too.
Right.
Okay. I'm not really. The raw food stuff, I think for me, my body, again, I think it's key to like know your body. What's right for your body will be different from someone else. So really understand how your body responds to food you eat. Mm-hmm. Just like I was telling you about the tomatoes, I couldn't help myself because we got them from the farm and they were so ripe and ready. And just like when you just, so good.
Yeah.
So I was just cooking with it for 2 weeks. And at a certain point, like you, I think you said, like someone was stabbing my abdomen with, I'm just like, what is this about? And hello, my body was like, bitch, the language. Girl.
You know what's so funny? Okay, sidebar. My mom washes these and I like
Miss Hunt.
Oh, what's up? Shout out to Miss Hunt. Sometimes I curse, but now that I know that she watches them, I'm like, oh, I always like kind of stop myself. But anyway, I'm like, mom, I'm going to curse. I'm sorry.
But, you know, you can't be cursing in front of your mama.
I know, but I'm just like, you chose to watch it. So, wait. So before we wrap up, I always like to play like a little game. I mean, we're not like drinking. We're not doing like alcohol right now, but we can still play a drinking game.
Yeah. We're still drinking.
So usually the drinking game is who would you, just answering these two questions, or you can, you don't have to answer both, but I always like to try to get people to answer both. Who would you have drinks with, would you want to have drinks with now that's living, that you're like, oh my gosh, like, I want to like go out to drinks with this person.
Oh Lord.
Living, okay. And or no longer with us.
Oh. Living is gonna be, there's this, why don't you tell me, ask me this before? So I could really,
I didn't prep her at all. So maybe you want me to start? And maybe that.
Yeah, go ahead. Okay. And I'll sip on this spritzer, maybe it'll help me.
I give you no preparation, yes. This literally, this thought just came to my mind just because I just watched an interview with him on the news, and I don't ever watch the news, but the only reason why I watched it is because a good friend of mine, shout out to Nancy, what's up Nancy? Nancy is the booking producer on the Ari Melber show on MSNBC, and she booked Billy Porter on the show. And I watched it and I was like, oh, you know, I really love what he's saying. And obviously, I mean, who doesn't love Billy Porter? He just seems like his energy is so infectious. But also,
and he's so free within himself.
He's so free within himself. Right, exactly. Like, he just felt so free, so like black and free. Like what he was saying, he just had no sense of like editing himself for like an audience that is probably predominantly white, right? Maybe, yeah, like a progressive white audience, but it's still a white audience. And he just felt, he was just so free with it. And I just, I love it. And also, girl, his skin, that skin was fitting. It was like, I'm like, what do you use on your face? Like, skin was just, it looked like, I don't know. I mean, it looked like he had been eating raw foods all day.
Girl. He had a couple of sessions out here. Isn't he based in LA?
You know, I actually think he's based in New York.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's what she told me. But anyway, I would want to like, you know, definitely mix and compete with him over a cocktail and talk about whatever his skin regimen is.
Yes, girl. Yes. Yes. I would want to know. Okay, I'm just going to chime in on that too. I love anyone that's just free to just be who they are with no filter, not worrying about who's here, what anyone thinks, because that's like the ultimate sense of freedom, right? You're expressing your like your authentic voice. And yeah, I would want to sit with him too and hear a little bit of something
to
about
get that.
All that energy. Just like rub up on me.
Yeah, right. Like just to you know, feel like super empowered.
Especially now.
Yes.
Especially now, because we did not have time to be like
filtered. No, life is, you know, and
nobody.
Speaking of that, like rest in peace, Chadwick Boseman.
Yes, yes, silence.
Really hurt my heart and everyone's hearts, right?
Yeah.
Definitely shows you, you know, life is short. But I will say he accomplished so waves, loads, like.
Much.
I truly feel like he was put here, he came to this earth to be a black superhero, which has never been done on that presented in on that scale. Right. To have that possibility model and just have generations of kids that can look up to a black
So because you live on within their minds, their you know,
exactly.
You just continue.
Like, it almost like, it's like he just sort of dropped the mic. He's like, okay, you know?
I'm out.
Yeah, I know, but rest in peace, but
Yeah. Okay. Who was the person that passed?
Well, actually now, I mean, I think it would be Chadwick, like, you know? Yeah.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, but yes, it would be Chadwick.
Okay. someone that passed, sounds so Bob Marley.
Yeah.
So he could be my boyfriend.
Yeah, he would be your boy. Okay, girl. Where's Joe at? Yeah, I hope he didn't hear that.
You're come like, on. I'm just gonna speak my free word. I'm gonna
be free. He's like, oh, okay, I get it. Yeah.
He's behind closed doors, so he's all right. But yeah. No. Just to like speak to him. I remember in college, you know how we had electives and it'll be like I don't know. It was like a free course, basically. You take it because you want an easy A, whatever.
Yeah.
This one was like creative something, something or the other. And we had to do an essay on an artist or whatever. And I chose Bob Marley. And just going through the lyrics, I think it was, I'm spazzing now, but one particular song, I'm like, every single thing you're saying, wow, the meaning behind everything you're saying, just to even like process it, to experience that and that to come from you, I just want to talk to you. And yeah. I think we should be, you know, in a relationship.
Ooh, because more than talking. Okay, yes.
And then to have a proper conversation would be Mariella, you know Mariella.
Yeah, of course. That's Mariella. Hey, Mariella.
Yes, hey, Mariella. Her, her partner, Stefan Dweck, his mom just passed away, but just from knowing Mariella and hearing about her conversations with Miss Mildred Dweck and just reading her essay a couple of days ago, my God, this woman is so inspiring. Oh. Like, she came up from, like, she was in, I think they grew up in the South and moved to New York, but then just hearing her experiences and just how firm and just clear on who she is and what she wants out of life and how she just stuck to that and did not compromise from no one and molded her life to fit what she wanted, you know? Mm-hmm. So just to have that conversation or have that as a mentor, I feel like that would be so awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
Yeah.
She lived a full life. She lived a full life. So, yeah, you know, even with Chadwick, he passed soon, but it seemed like he really accomplished a lot.
Life, yeah, it definitely, yeah, it felt so that way, yeah,
and we don't know what's next, right? We don't know what's outside of here. They could just be like, "Whew, we made it through."
Listen, that's what the pandemic has definitely taught, you know, a lot of us. It's just like, we're still here, so let's just do it. We'll do it in a defined way, in a
right.
No, I'm not in a way that has an
asterisk on it. Yeah, man. And person alive, I'm just going to go with Michelle Obama. Because I can't think of, not because I can't think of anyone else, but she's amazing. I don't care what. I find so much strength and so much inspiration from listening to her. Like, I remember one of the early speeches she did for a graduating class. That inspired me so much. And talking about vibrations, I literally can feel vibrations like through me, like inspiration, like I feel it. And just when I hear her speak, and then the other week she was speaking too, I'm like, Joe Biden. And I wasn't like that the whole time. I was like, what you want me to do, Miss Obama?
Like, girl, you tell me whoever you want me to vote for and I will do it.
She said, make sure you register to vote. I said, all right.
Like, okay, you're like, that's so funny.
Have that power, that grace, that voice of hers, you know, I would want to have her as a mentor and talk to. Because that's just,
everything. Which is, you know, that doesn't come immediately. Like, you
know, it doesn't.
Work your way up to that. So it would be nice to pick her brain on, like, how she... You know, it's like that comfortability that you're talking about, that comfort you are, is how you're able to
and just navigate through different things, also because of what she went through, but she held her head up high.
Yeah,
like, come on, if she could be scrutinized as much as she did
right,
and still raise her family, did her thing, and you know, like, I don't have nothing to complain about.
Listen,
so that's what I want to talk about too. Like, okay, so let's really be real. When they come at you this way, how is it that you just come out so gracefully, you know, with the words? Because I would just be so
she's in the basement boxing from
So that's what I would want notes on.
Huh?
Yeah. I said I would want notes on like how to come back. Yeah, real gracefully.
That energy. Yeah.
That's it.
She probably has like crystals in her pocket.
Yeah, and then like,
yeah. Okay. Oh, yeah. That note, Missy. Thank you so much.
Yes, April. This is lovely. It was good to see you.
Good to see you. I love you, Ololade, aka Lola.
Love you, girl.
Okay. And yes. I'm gonna post all your stuff, your link to your world, your jewelry on the page.
Yes. All right.
Bye.
Bye, June. Bye, everyone. Thank you, April.